Hey guys, it is me, HappyCairek, and welcome back to our free-to-play series in Last on Earth Survival. So today, for the first time ever, we're gonna go to the farm location. Because look at the left side, it says find out what happened, return to the farm. So that's what we're gonna do, we're gonna return to the farm, and I've already taken all of the resources necessary to repair the bridge. So without any further ado, let's just go there. And who knows, after the farm location, there is a high chance that we're gonna go to this Bunker Alpha. I kept saying that we're gonna go to Bunker Alpha for the past few episodes, because I really wanted to go to that Bunker Alpha, but apparently Act 1 didn't want me to go there. Because we can go to that Bunker Alpha only at the end of Act 1, and we are on Chapter 5 Bunker Alpha Mission 2, so soon, guys. Very soon, we're gonna be able to get to that Bunker Alpha. But hey, we're gonna talk about that Bunker Alpha a bit later. It's time for us to assemble this bridge. So let's just drop all of the resources necessary. Bam, and let's finalize the bridge. And there we go. We'll never have to repair this bridge ever again. So we've just unlocked here the farm location and find out what happened. Inspect the farm. So yes, we are definitely gonna inspect the farm. I've already looted this thing last time, so we cannot reloot it again. And hey, I've taken all of the resources, all of the weapons, and it looks like this farm location is already different. Usually you have here two rotten yokels standing at the end of the bridge here, but this time we've only gotten one rotten yokel, and boom, we've just leveled up. So let's go to skills. Probably we're gonna get the bruiser perk. It's fine. We're gonna have some more health. Let's get this rope. For now, I'm gonna pick up everything. And yes, it might feel like we've taken way too many items. I've taken here another set. I've taken here some melee weapons. Wait, we're actually going to go and break this cleaver first. But lots of these weapons are going to break, plus this armor that I have here is going to break. So it is kind of nice that we've taken more items. So this is not the real farm location. This is probably like half of the farm location, because later on it's going to reset and then we'll be able to clear it, because as of right now, it looks a little bit different. Usually here at the very beginning, we should have a savage giant, but we do not have one. But hey, let's deal here with this fast biter. Let's take the rest of the resources. Wait, is that a... No, that's not a human. I thought that's gonna be a human. So check this out. You can even wall trick these fast biters just like that again. It's gonna take a little bit of practice. And that's how you're gonna clear this entire farm location. Let's say zombies do too much damage. For example, those savage giants, you can just lure them here and just wall trick them at this place, and that should work. But for now, we haven't seen here a single savage giant, so we will definitely see that later. Yes, indeed, the farm location looks even different. Look at this. There's a pickup truck blocking the way, so I cannot go there. Apparently, I cannot go there either because there are haystacks. So we probably gotta go through this side. All right, we're definitely gonna do this. So I definitely maybe over-prepared. But as always, it is better to over-prepare than not take enough things. So I'd rather take more things. There you go. Let's deal with the rotten yokel. Goodbye. Plus, we're getting some points towards the season pass. Wait, let's go over here. I mean, we can take some of the rewards. We've gotten 10 of those iron bars. And the Blackport PD. Okay, we still cannot do it because we need to restore the Eastern Watchtower. So one day we're gonna do this. And plus we have this event, the Big Hunt event, that's not really much worth it even for this account. So yeah. But hey, we still have this wrecked ship event that's gonna last for 12 more hours. So we kind of have to go there. So maybe today we'll go to that wrecked ship event as well, because I wouldn't mind that. So yeah, let's kind of go further. Probably this zombie's gonna wake up and we're gonna break our cleaver any moment. There we go. The cleaver is gone. Let's deal with the fast biter. Let's get the crowbar. Again, I'd rather save these crowbars for Bunker Alpha, but we also have to clear this place. So we're gonna do this. Okay, there's a fox. Goodbye, fox. Foxes can give us some fur and some raw meat. Again, fur is gonna be useful if we ever gonna craft some armor, some fur armor, if you want to go to the northern location. But I don't know if we're ever gonna go there. Maybe one day. I'm gonna get these foxes just for the sake of meat. That's gonna be useful. Okay, so usually around this place we can find a ravager, aka the revenger, but this time we couldn't find anything, because as I said, this is a different scenario right now. The farm location normally doesn't look like that. But I will deal with the rotten yokel. We are still exploring what happened here at the farm. Yes, indeed, we still have the same task. Or maybe we will get here our first revenger today. I don't know. Everything's possible. There we go. We got another rotten yokel. Goodbye, mate. And plus, we're going to loot these bags. Maybe we can get something useful in these bags, like, I don't know, beans, for example. Maybe we can find a bandage. Maybe we can also get a little bit of coal, even though I kind of don't want to bring that back to the base, as we have coal at the base, but... You know what? I'll take it. Okay, so this chest was kind of nice. We've gotten some raw hides. We've gotten some of those bolts, some planks, and some of the coal. That's good. That chest was pretty decent. Definitely nice. Well, let's hit something. Oh, get rid of the bowl. There is an infected bowl. Again, we could wall trick it, but I did bring this thing with us, so we're going to see how much damage it does. There we go. There is an infected bowl. And this infected bowl is a little bit faster than usual. How much damage will it do? Okay, it does 18 damage, so we could melee weapon it. We could use melee weapons, or we could wall trick it. But hey, I brought this Glock, so I'm gonna use this Glock. As I said, it's always nice to bring with you a weapon every time you're going to an unknown location, because It'll be useful. It'll come in handy. There is a Leroy. Finally, I thought I'd never get out of here. Okay, who are you? Why are you here? Do I talk to you? That horned bastard chased me to the roof, and I just came here, blah, blah. Take me to the camp. It's about time we get into that bunker. Oh, so we're just gonna go to the bunker right now. Wait, before we go to that bunker, I can't open that up. Probably skill burglar level 1 required. I have no idea where the other village guy disappeared. Okay, cool. Okay, we're gonna get those things, except I don't have space for those bandages, so probably we're gonna get rid of these empty cans. And wait, let's go over here. Let's go to act, bam, and mission 2. There we go. Let's claim all of the rewards. Durability check. Getting ready is much easier when you're sober. We're finally finished packing. The only things left is to check the equipment, work up the nerve, and hit the road. So very soon, probably even today, we're gonna go to that bunker alpha for the first time ever. I do like that. Make final preparations. So we gotta go to the pine grove. We're gonna do that. I'm just gonna go and deal with a few more zombies. I don't think we'll be able to open this up. Farm chest required. Unless we have a chest here and we can open it up today. I kind of doubt it. Have you ever fought 2 floater bloaters at the same time? That's probably what the guy said. I guess so. I'm gonna check this place. And what if we got a box? If we don't have a box, maybe I just should skedaddle from here. Nope. Because maybe this farm location is not gonna have a box. Yeah, it doesn't really look like it has a box. Okay, let's deal with this rotten yokel. Let's get that. Plus, we got a poppy. Let's pick up the poppy. Except our inventory is full. Lots of the resources here are more valuable than that puppy. I mean, we're gonna get rid of the fur. I'm never gonna craft that armor, not anytime soon, so I might as well just get rid of it. So now let's try to find a way out of this place and let's get back to the base. So it's time for us to go to the pine grove. I also went back to the base and dropped off some resources just so that our inventory looks a bit better. This way we're gonna have some more space. And I'm almost 90% sure that today is the day when we're gonna go to that farm location. Wow, that's a lot of floater bloaters, lots of enemies. I don't even know if I was supposed to gather all of them at the same time, but maybe they're gonna help me out. So I'm just bringing these guys to me. Maybe they'll help me out. I doubt it though. Nope, they're not gonna help me out. Look at this. Stop shooting into nothing and help me. That'd be way better if that dude had just helped me, but that's fine. I'll do it on my own. There we go. Dealt with all of them. It's time for us to talk to them. Find the marine. Okay, finally, there we go. There's the dude. Check the gear. Let's check the gear. About the time you showed up. Okay, let's check the gear. We got this thing over here. Look at all of those VSSs. Wish I could take all of them with me. That'd be nice. There we go. We just checked it. Talk to somebody else. We just had something to do there. Talk to the shooter. There we go. There's the shooter. Welcome. What we're about to see has no comparison. Prove you can handle a weapon or you'll die. Shoot in the shooting range. What if I don't have the thing? What if I just attack this thing? Look at this. We could either shoot or maybe I could just fist punch this thing. That'd be better. But do I really have to shoot it or do I have to punch it? Maybe we have to shoot it, but what if I don't have a gun? How many more shots do I have to do? Shoot in the shooting range. How many more shots do I have to do? Is that it? Is that it? There we go. Finally, we did it. I just wasted my Glock because of those idiots. That felt so wrong. That felt so wrong. Talk to the rescued man from the farm. Where's that dude? The guy's gotta be around this place. There you go, Leroy, welcome. I'm kind of worried, man. Can you get me something stronger? Bring the alcohol. Okay, let's find it. Look, he just needs one bottle of whiskey. Let's find it. Maybe we'll find what we need here in this vehicle. I also see there another chest, so we're gonna check that out. And I don't have any nice melee weapons, so we're just gonna use the sawblade mace, which it's kind of decent, but I'd rather sneak attack with it. Just attack those guys like that. And there you go, we've just leveled up, so we're gonna definitely check what kind of perk we've just gotten there. We've gotten some gasoline, bottles of water, and whatever other items. I'll just take that. And let's try to level up. Anything useful? Just a homebody perk. Let's get it. Let's max it out. And here we've gotten some more water, so I think I'll have to get back to the base. Yeah, I think that's what I'll have to do. We'll have to go back to the base to get that whiskey. So I had to go back all the way to the farm location because I didn't have any whiskey at the base, so I could get it only here. And I'm pretty certain that's not it. There will be some other preparations and some sort of another dude will want me to bring something else. I don't remember what, but I'm like 90% certain we'll have to go back to the base again. We're gonna use all of the energy. They want us to use all of the energy today. Lay me into that bunker alpha. That's all I'm asking. Okay, there's a phone. I don't need it. And yes, I've looted all of the chests here. There's nothing here. We had to go back to the base. All right, Leroy, there we go. Take it. Took me a while to get it. I'm kind of worried, man. There we go. Just what the doctor ordered. Yes, indeed. Just what the doctor ordered. Now, what else do we have to do? Make final preparations. Doesn't say anything. Durability check. Maybe we got to talk to this guy. There we go. We'll have to bring something to him. Almost ready. What do you want? What do you want, mate? Oh, no. Duct tapes and batteries. I don't have those things. And if I had, I brought them back to the base. 2 duct tapes and 1 battery. Well, we got duct tapes in the inventory, but I don't think we got any batteries here. Yeah, I'll have to go back for the batteries. I can't believe that. There we go. Let's get 2 duct tapes and let's get 1 battery. Hopefully I have it. We should have a battery somewhere here. There we go. We got 5 batteries. There we go, let's get it. So there we go, after 84 years of preparations, we are finally here. We are done, hopefully. There we go, let's give that stuff. Thanks, I'll get it back to you if we're alive. Okay, return to the marine. Finally, are we ready? Are we ready? All the preparations are complete. We can head out. There we go, return to Bunker Alpha. We did it. We can finally go to Bunker Alpha. And guess what? I already have all of the resources necessary. Let's go over here. Let's complete those things. We've gotten some more rewards. Let's get that. And lost shelter. Having assembled a team, we developed a plan. We thought out everything to the smallest detail. No, we didn't. All we have to do is get into the bowels of the bunker and solve its mysteries. And also take everything we can get our hands on. So, ladies and gentlemen, finally, the moment has come. We are finally going to Bunker Alpha. For the past few episodes, I kept saying that we're going to Bunker Alpha, but today we are actually going to that Bunker Alpha. Luckily, I still have enough energy, so let's go there. I also brought all the resources we need. I brought some healing items. I brought some armor, some guns. There we go. Look at all of them. They're all waiting. And now we're all here. Let's start the operation. I guess we can do it. Talk to the Marine. I just talked to him, no? All right. Over there, we can get a Glock card. Don't tell me I had to bring an Alpha card. Don't you dare to tell me that. I'm gonna be very sad. This guy's gonna have a bunker password. I did not bring an Alpha card, dude. I'll give the command as soon as you open the door. Gotta go back to the base for the Alpha card. It's unbelievable. I won't have enough energy to get there. I thought that they are gonna have this Alpha card. I didn't know that I have to bring it. And there we go. We are finally here. So let's drop this Alpha card. Bam. Let's finalize it. And look at that. Finally, we are in Bunker Alpha. So I've just opened the door. And okay, finally, they're going to follow me here. I thought maybe something's going to lag. Enter the code and come down. We're going to definitely enter that code. It's over here. So 8 to 830. 8 to 830. Let's go over here. 8 to 830. There we go. Let's confirm that. And boom, we're going to enter into this bunker, baby. We did it. But before we go even deeper, we're probably going to go and loot all of these lockers. Because for those who don't know, all of the lockers up here, they don't reset. So you can store all of your loot here. Again, be careful. Because at least at the moment of recording this video, raiders cannot raid the loot here. But who knows what's going to happen. As developers always say, the safest place to store your resources is at your own base. So if you want to store anything here, store it at your own risk. It's just that if something ever happens, you know, maybe like 3 updates from now, maybe a year from now, developers will update the game and maybe some loot will disappear from here, then I don't want people to blame me. But I kept my loot here for 5 years and nothing ever happened. So I don't know if it's ever gonna happen. I mean, if they didn't remove those lockers for 5 years, maybe they're not gonna remove them for the next 5 years. But I'm just saying, be warned. If I was you, I would store here my weapons, I would store my armor, and maybe I would store some healing items so that every time I have to come to Bunker Alpha, I'll have all of my resources in these lockers. So I've opened all of these lockers, but it didn't even take any loot yet. All right, well, for now, let's keep those things over here and let's go deeper. I mean, we also have this broken armor. I mean, we might as well just equip it because this other broken armor is gonna break any moment, so it doesn't matter. There we go. Let's go into Bunker Alpha for the first time ever in this account. And now Bunker Alpha is gonna become 80% of our gameplay. Stay alert. We don't know what we can face this time. Personally, I'm ready for anything. I have no idea why this guy's standing on top of these seats, but hey, that's fine. Let's loot the vending machine. Sometimes the vending machine can have some food, and food is always appreciated. And this time we have indeed got a little bit of canned food, so let's get that canned food. Let's stack it. Let's open that up and let's start dealing with all of these zombies. Maybe they're gonna deal with this fast biter on their own, but hey, give me the experience. I want to get it on my own. I'm not gonna be able to open that door. I'll open this and maybe someone's gonna help me out with this zombie over there. There we go. Just deal with it. Just deal with it. No, the guy's... Oh, the guy will indeed help me out. There we go. I've also gotten some experience. Over there, we can take a shower. That is lovely. And let's open up now another door. Let's inspect the lobby. Bam. I'm probably going to go and deal with all the zombies up here. We can bring coupons. You can get rewards. I don't know who invented this dispenser, but it's very convenient. Yes, indeed. Okay, so the guy's going to start dealing with all these fast biters. And we started getting tags here. Why did we get a tag from the zombie? Kind of makes no sense. As we usually get coupons, not tags. There we go. Plus, we've gotten more tags. No, no, no. That's not how it works. We're supposed to get coupons. Maybe it's because like it's some sort of a mission. So Bunker Alpha looks a little bit different and we get a bit different loot than usual. So we are probably going to go now to the first floor, right? I mean, there's nothing much we can do right now. Let's go over here. This elevator leads to the next levels. Go down to the next floor. Okay, so we can only go now to the second floor. So let's go to the second floor, because we're not going to be able to go to the third or fourth floor if we don't do this mission. And I kind of want to finish Act 1, because after that we'll be able to start Act 2. One of the elders once said, "This door, corridor of death, I suggest you stay away from the walls." Are you sure you want to keep going? Personally, I'm not so sure. Okay, it's fine. There's four of us. We're going to do it. Okay, let's open up the door. Okay, so basically this bunker is in hard mode. That's why we are getting those tags. Maybe I'm supposed to get a shovel instead of that thing. That'd be better. Okay, some of these guys are probably gonna die. Wait, there were four of us. There are still four of us. Okay, so everything's fine. Let's get these tags here right now. Wish they were dropping coupons. That'd be more useful. Okay, let's deal with these floater bloaters. Let's heal up. These floater bloaters are kind of strong. They punch pretty hard. The only good thing about this is how much useful stuff we can find here. Yeah, I guess that's the whole point of Bunker Alpha. It's all about the loot. Watch out, beasts are just waiting to eat us up. It's fine. Maybe I'll eat them up first. Okay, there's a bunch of them here. We should be careful and quiet. Okay, who's this dude? Oh, there's a frenzy giant. There go. This guy's gonna get clapped. There go. The guy just died. Kill the giant. We're definitely gonna kill that giant. I do have a gun, so we could kill him with a gun. Again, guys, be very careful with this frenzy giant. It does lots of damage. It's probably gonna one-shot you if you don't have any armor. And if you have the armor, it's gonna do like 80-something damage, so be very careful. We're gonna definitely wall-trick it. Look at this. We can wall-trick it that way. Plus, this guy's gonna help us out with the gun. But yeah, be very careful while wall-tricking. It's gonna take some practice, but once you master it, you're gonna be unbeatable. And that's how you're kind of supposed to clear this entire bunker out. Just bring enough healing items, bring enough weapons, and wall trick as many zombies here as possible, and you're gonna get rich. There we go. Let's deal with this guy. Plus, we've gotten some experience. Let's also get this military notebook. It doesn't kind of fit. Okay, so we're gonna take that military notebook kind of soon. Okay, this guy's already dead. That's sad. And they're not even gonna say anything about him unless they've said something and I did not see that. Okay, let's get some loot. I'll get... Okay, that doesn't fit. We definitely need more space in the inventory. That's for sure. We even need a bigger backpack, because whatever backpack we got here, that's not enough. Let's get those beans. I'll open this thing up. Why do they keep following me so closely? Why do they stick to me so close? That's fine. Let's get the canned food. I wanted to say cat food. Let's get that canned food. We got two bottles of water. I totally don't need that. Wait, let's get rid of that water. We have enough water at the base. Let's get those things. And now I think we can progress further. Let's open up the door. Can I open these doors up? Probably they're locked. So there we go. We can just go here then. Do we have anything else? Yes, indeed. Let's go further. There we go. Just lost my pants. Let's loot the shelf. And soon we're probably going to get a new armor. Let's get those things. I'd love to get this glue and iron bar, but I don't have space, so we're not taking it. Maybe I'll take that later. Maybe we'll bring everything to the top. Maybe, maybe. Let's disable the gas. And I have no idea how this guy got there. This dude is gonna die. Yikes. Try to move there, but the guy's dead. He thought he knew how to defeat the big one. Well, he didn't. But did you see he's done a roll there? That was kind of cool. He did a pretty cool roll, but he still died. Okay, so we're gonna avoid that turret. Careful, this turret will kill if you don't break it quicker. So there go, the guy's gonna deal with that turret. Go and destroy that turret, mate. How much more health that turret has? That is insane. Maybe I can get a Glock of my own. Okay, the turret had almost no health. There we go. They just destroyed it. This is amazing. Let's also get rid of this. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna die! In certain locations, you risk losing your items, but this time you can restore them. Let's restore. Whoa! I did not expect that the turret's gonna be there. I thought that... I don't know what I thought. I thought the guy killed it. It had one health and then boom. Well, usually you lose your items or you're not going to be able to pick them up. But hey, this time they allowed me to take it and I respawned back at the base. So let's go back to that Bunker Alpha. But usually when you die there, you lose all of your items in that Bunker Alpha. So then you have to go back there and pick up those items. But hey, apparently it's like some sort of a mission. This game is still teaching us how to play it. So it's all fine. So we're back in Bunker Alpha. So I assume that a lot of players died there as well. Like, maybe that was the first death for a lot of players. But I do believe that lots of players died there. Because you don't really expect that turret to shoot you. That guy destroyed it. I literally saw it have one health and then boom. And then he got closer to that turret. It stopped shooting him. So why on earth would that shoot me then? Let's get another Glock. Perhaps I'll take some armor. There we go. That's going to help us out. We have some healing items. Okay. And let's deal with that turret here right now. How much health does it have even? There goes, gonna start shooting it again. There go, now it's dead. Now it's gone, no? There go, now we have the... There we go. I just wasted so many healing items. Damn it! But we did it. Finally, we have destroyed this turret fully. Usually, it doesn't work like this. Usually, you destroy that turret, and there we go. It stays destroyed. But something must have happened here. It's weird. It's weird. It is really stupid. But hey, we did it. We survived. That's all what matters. There we go. Let's get... Imagine this turret wakes up again and it starts shooting me. That'd be ridiculous. That would be such a huge scam. But hey, let's deal with a few more of the zombies. Let's pick up the rest of the loot. And maybe I'm even gonna... You know what? Let's equip this armor. I just want to break it and then we'll equip the other one. Let's just be efficient. Plus, I kind of don't want to delete it as it takes some time to delete it. It'll take me 3 seconds to delete that armor. Why delete it when zombies can delete that stuff for you? There we go. Let's deal with another toxic spitter. Let's get the rest of those chevrons. Which, again, as I said, I'd rather get those coupons than chevrons. As chevrons are going to take us a while. Because you need lots of chevrons to open up and get a floppy crate. So, yeah... Okay, let's deal with that. Plus, now I think we can go and equip this other thing. There we go. Let's equip this new armor. There we go. That's much better. So yeah, as I said, chevrons are going to take us a while to collect because you need lots of chevrons to get a floppy crate. And we're not getting that floppy crate anytime soon. So basically, we're just clearing this bunker alpha now for fun. But we have to do it. We have to start clearing it. Oh no, the guy just went after someone. Leroy died, lived without fear and died without it. Okay, we got to be kind of careful. We're going to activate this thing. Clear the storeroom. Oh, there's somebody here. Look at this. We're going to save this guy. Usually it took us a while to get him, but now we're going to get him like right now. So I guess that's cool. Let's open that up. There's a toxic abomination. Usually there are two of those big zombies. There is toxic abom and a floater bloater. This guy's just going to look at me and not help me. Okay, this guy's helping me out again. We could probably wall trick him. Let's save some healing items. There we go. There's no need to waste our healing items on these toxic bombs. You are getting the basic idea of how to clear this farm location. You just try to wall trick everything. But this is still not the real Bunker Alpha. Because once it resets, once we are done with this mission, Bunker Alpha is going to look a bit different. So yeah, let's try to save this guy. Oh, this dude's name's Jordan. This guy is a specialist. We lost almost everyone. We have to leave. Return to the lobby. Thanks. Lucky you're here. There we go. Get out of here. I think we can work together. So there we go. Let's meet in the overseer's room. Okay, so we're definitely gonna go there. Plus, we just finished another task here. So we are gonna check it out. We've gotten some more iron, some more of those things. Let's get it. And let's probably get those rewards. There we go. Let's claim all of the rewards. How do you get life to laugh? Tell her about your plans. We thought we were ready, but things turned out to be much more difficult. But giving up is not an option. Who knows what other secrets Alpha may keep. Okay, so let's go back to the lobby. But before we go there, maybe I can loot some of these things. Okay, that's a lot of zombies there. It's kind of pointless to fight them anyways, as they don't drop any tickets. So why would I bother, right? Let's go back to the first floor. Now we can clear a third and fourth floor. Okay, that's interesting. But before we do any of that, we got to talk to this guy over here in the lobby. There we go. Let's talk to him. You helped me big time. Now it's my turn. I'll give you some advice on how to handle this place. I know how to do it. I'm not quite sure how and how if this thing still works, but having a couple of coupons will help you score big time. You can find a bunch of them. Blah, blah, blah. Maybe we... Wait, if I'm not mistaken, maybe we can get something in the trash bin. Maybe, or maybe that's not the case. Nah, it's probably in another... I'm confusing it with some sort of another quest for maybe another new year. This place where you get the goods, but to access it, you'll need a fingerprint. Where you get it, it's not my business. Okay, we do have that fingerprint at the base. Wish I brought it here. Wish I had it with me. Okay, this guy's walking very slowly. I think we can walk slowly here as well. There we go, let's... walk after this dude. He's gonna introduce us to this place. I should have brought that finger. At least I would have brought more loot back to the base. Oh yeah, thanks, I suppose. You're welcome. It all went wrong. We're lucky we survived this mess. At least both of us survived. Talk to the engineer. Let's talk to this guy. That would be all for now. And yeah, thanks again. I won't forget something like that. I can modify your weapon. That was my job. Was. Okay, so you no longer modify weapons. Back in the days when this game came out, this dude could modify your weapons, but he doesn't do that anymore. Open the crate from the conveyor. So we gotta open up 3 crates. And there we go. Over here, we can get those things. To this dude, we can give these items, right? There we go. Let's just give him some of these hard mode items. And as I said, it's going to require us lots of those tags just to be able to get one of those floppy crates. And yeah, over here, we can drop those blueprints that we don't need and we'll get some other blueprints. But yeah, now our main quest is to open up a few of those crates. We got to open up 3 of those crates. So we can open up probably 3 green ones and that'll be fine. But to open up those 3 green ones, we need to clear Bunker Alpha first. And we can't really clear it as hard mode is kind of set right now. But hey, what we can do is sort out these lockers. So let's try to quickly sort that stuff out. Because because these lockers are kind of messy as of right now. So there, guys, sorted some of these chests. So I'll be bringing some stuff back to the base little by little. But I think for now, we're going to store this mess over here. Also, there's a tip and trick. As I already said, you can store these items here. So I usually keep my coupons in Bunker Alpha. There's no point for you to bring them back to the base, as you can't really open up those tickets at your base. You can only use them in Bunker Alpha. So I'm going to store them here. And hey, now let's see our survival guide. So, okay, we can get some more items from it. There we go. Let's get some duct tape. Let's get some of those saw blade maces, some first aid kits. And there are a bunch of other tasks we need to do. And we have only like, what, 6 days to finish these tasks. But at least somehow, some way, we have enough energy to get to this wrecked ship event, because we haven't gotten lots of loot in that Bunker Alpha. But again, what's important is that we have unlocked it. Now we'll have to wait until this thing resets, and then we'll be able to start clearing it properly. We're gonna start getting their green coupons, yellow coupons, red coupons. We'll open a bunch of crates, and we are gonna get rich. So that's it. We basically did it. We've opened up Bunker Alpha. So that is awesome. And yeah, what else is awesome is this wrecked ship event. So let's get some more free loot. But before I deal with more zombies, let's get some more perks. I think we could get this neat freak. I mean, why not? Let's just get it. Doesn't really matter. As I said, the best perks are gonna be the burglar perk and the extra pocket perk. And so far, we haven't gotten either of those. Perhaps one day we'll get that. Again, I'm kind of using my shovel on these fast biters. I wish I didn't. I think it's better to use the scroll bar. But that shovel's gonna break kind of soon, though. You know what? Let's just break it fully. We're not gonna bring that thing back to Bunker Alpha. So there we go. Let's deal with these guys. And now we can start using the crowbar once that shovel broke. And then we're gonna get some free loot from this place. There are two more zombies to deal with. One fast biter, and there go one more fast biter. And all we have to do is just open up one green crate in that Bunker Alpha, and then we're gonna start getting loot. And it should be relatively easy, because we have a bunch of weapons here inside of the inbox. I mean, we have flare guns, we have skull crushers, we have cleavers, metal pipes. So it's gonna be very easy to clear like the first few floors in that Bunker Alpha. Plus, we have some healing items. We have 45 bandages, we have a bunch of jerky, plus we have lots of loot at the base. So it is gonna be relatively easy to clear the first few floors in that Bunker Alpha. So that's kind of cool. There we go, let's deal with that survivor. If I were him, I would not be standing under this crate, but whatever, you do you. Let's open that stuff up. I'd rather get a shotgun here, and we've gotten nothing but this lands. Okay, I guess thanks. Free loot, kind of not free. It was pointless loot. I'd rather get those 5 copper bars, but we didn't. So let's start walking to the base, because I have no more energy left. And hey, luckily today we have unlocked this Bunker Alpha. Soon we will start opening up crates in that Bunker Alpha, and we'll start getting rich in no time. So make sure to subscribe to not miss those videos. And hey, listen, just to check it out, my Scum Survival Let's Player, click on the second card and look at my The Long Dark Let's Player. Hop over to my channel, go to playlist, and there you'll find a lot of other games that I played here on the channel. If you're not subscribed yet, definitely make sure to jump the subscribe button and notification bell to not miss any future videos. And consider following me on Instagram or Twitter at HappyCairek. Yep.